Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. It is me, Ralphie993, and in the last week's episode, we took on a Royal Ludroth, in the Flooded Forest. This episode, we're going to tackle BARROTH, the first Brute Wyvern of the game, I think, and we're going to see him in my pretty pink teddy bear armor. I don't know, this is Rhinoplus? The rhino dinosaurs that I don't like from the Kuropeko episode. This armor is made from their bodies, and it works decently well. It's a pretty weak armor that I have. Actually, it's the weakest armor I have. However, it'll help us out with the BARROTH fight that we do have coming up, because one of his signature moves is that he can shake mud off of his body, and that can incapacitate us for a little while. So I decide to wear this armor, because it doesn't allow the mud to stick to us, so we'll be set for that. The BARROTH's armor is also interesting because he has a dirty body covered in mud and a clean body. And what you want to do is that there's different elemental weapons that work for each. So water works for the muddy body, fire works for the clean body, and I'm using an ice weapon which works decently well on both. So that's what we're going to do there. So let's select our quest. I think it's this one. It's 3 stars, leading the charge, we'll hunt ourselves a BARROTH. So let's do that. Take care, you two guild sweethearts. I think, what are they called? Guild sweethearts, I think? I don't know. Leading the charge. Alright, let's gather our goodies and prepare for our quest. We got lots of stamina and lots of health that I got from the kitty cook. And let's pick up the things that we'll need. Those other items there are for gunners who use bows and heavy bow guns and light bow guns, that sort of stuff. These guys, this is the armor that I'm wearing. These ones. And it's dead. But whatever. That's not my problem. Alright, so we're gonna find ourselves a BARROTH. I think they usually like to chill out in Area 3 where it's muddy, and that's usually where I tend to find them right away. So let's head that way. Whoops. There we go. A bunch of little jaggies running around. Being adorable. Jaggies would be a cute pet if you knew they wouldn't, like, eat you and rip you apart, which I'm sure they would. They're like velociraptors, I imagine. That wouldn't be a good pet to have. But yes, you can see that thing moving about in the mud? That would be our friend, BARROTH. So let's try to sneak up on him. I don't know if we can sneak up on him. And we'll get real close. Let's get him on the head! Bam! Ouch! Ouch, sir! Yes, actually, and I think the other thing too, this is the BARROTH, we're up close and personal, because it's cute. Oh yeah, he's also the first one who roars, and it actually has an effect on us. Alright, actually, I'm going to want to kind of, get out from him. He can do some heavy damage when he hits you. Won't deny it. Oh my gosh, sir, no, please. I don't want to. I don't want to be a part of it. Oh, that's going to not get me, apparently. I dodged out of the way. But yeah, his head isn't the greatest to hit if you have a sword, even if it's green sharpness. However, if you do have a more impact damage versus cutting damage. Oh, I did not mean to do that. That's usually a signature move there too, by the way, as well. This is like charge thing. I'm back here. I wish to slice you up. Actually, not the greatest. Oh my gosh, with this guy with a long sword. So, why did I bring it? Because the element's good, right? And everything's about elements. Wrong. It's not about elements. Anyways, let's chop up your feet. See if we can get a few combos off on him. Okay, I'm good. I'm out of the way. Out of the way, please. I don't want to be a part of that. Oh, he's doing a tail swipe. Get out of the way for that. A tail can do quite a bit of hefty damage. So let's actually put our sword away. What is he doing? What are you doing? I want to get that shiny thing that's underneath you, sir. Please move. Grab that. Hurry up before he gets me. Oh, he's not looking at me. He's looking at Kayumba. Did he even paypal him? What's he doing? Oh, right. I thought he was going to go to sleep. And I'm like, buddy, you can't go to sleep yet. We're not at that stage of the game. Oh, my gosh. The safest part is probably actually directly underneath him. Oh, was he roaring? I can't tell. Sometimes the bodies can be too big. Oh, out of the way. Alright, good. He does that move, and then he can run up like close to him. Wait for his tail to go back down, though. Oh, I think I totally missed that. Alright. Let's put away our swords so we can run a little bit faster. I think he might be mad. He might be enraged. He's got some some steam coming out of his head. His eyes are kind of red. Sir, where are you going? Stop making the craziness, sir. Oh, there we go. I think we did some damage there. I feel like I don't want to be in a corner. I don't want to be here. I don't want to be here. No! Oh my gosh, it was close. Alright, run up to him. Slashy slash. Yeah, slash him in the face. Right where this doesn't actually work. Alright. Give him the legs. I think his lower legs are a pretty good weak spot. If you can aim for it. Oh! Boy, oh boy, oh boy. Alright. Just gotta keep wailing at him. That's all there really is. Oh, and you know, aim actually at his body when you... When you attack him. Oh boy, he does damage. Why did I bring my sword? I would have been better off to bring my hammer. Lady, why didn't you run? Celeste. Yeah, my character's name's Celeste. Not my actual name, clearly. Thank you, Barroth. Oh, he's got some drippy drools. He's getting tired. Oh yeah, he's resting. He's tired. Let's get a few combos off of him. I won't get the next kind of colored rage mode of my sword, but that's all right. Oh no, I don't want to be a part of this. I don't want to be a part of this. Thank you, little buddies, my little friends. They're my little buddies. That's their names. Oh no, not your face. I wish not to hit your face. He's actually decently fast for a big guy. Oh no. Actually, I should probably heal up or something. Or, you know, attack him, perhaps. Or get out of the way. Get out of the way is good, too. Seems to have no signs of being tired. Oh my gosh, I almost ran right in front of him. Alright, where are you going? He's just running around. Oh, I think he's gonna leave the area, which I don't have him paintballed, but that's okay, because he gives a pretty good dead giveaway of where he's going. You can see the poofs of dirt show up, and that's where he's going. He can apparently bury through the ground. There's an absurd amount of monsters that can bury through the ground. I'm just gonna say, it's kind of odd. I didn't think they would be able to do it. Apparently they can. Alright, hello, Barroth. Oh yes, because he's tired, he's gonna break this open, and I think he's gonna eat little ants. Don't quote me on that. The ants that also, they like to come over and hang out with me and be like, oh hey, I'm gonna attack you, even though you're attacking the thing that eats me for dinner. Alright, can we get some good combos off? I'd say we did pretty well. We got the next glowy bit. We got white around our sword now, which is awesome. Alright. Yeah, he's down. Alright, run over to him. Yeah, cha-cha, go Koyama. Get him while he's down. Get him while he's down. He's helpless. This is the second time he's actually fallen really quick in a row. Alright, get some more combos. Sorry you can hear tons of butt smashing, but some part of it kind of is a lot of button mashing. Oh, I think he's mad again. I don't want to... Ow. Well, I became a part of it. Ant, go away! Nobody loves you! All the little ones, they all want their time in the spotlight. Oh, oh my gosh. Guys, oh, fertile mud. That's good. That's good for growing stuff. I'll take that. Alright. Can you stop running around, please? Oh, I was able to actually slash through his face. That's interesting. Ant, go away! I don't care about your problems, your ant problems. Bug's Life never made me care. Oh, ants never made me care. Well, they made me care a little bit. Actually, Bug's Life just affirmed that I really, really don't like not spiders, grasshoppers. I do not like grasshoppers. After seeing Hopper, it's terrified me. Oh, crap. Jeez. Gosh, look at that damage. All right, can we heal ourselves? I also need to sharpen my weapon. Cha-Cha, keep him busy! Cha-Cha! Guys, Cha-Cha and Kayamba are pretty much my, oh, what do you want to call them without being rude? They're my beating bags. They can take all the beatings for me so I can, like, sharpen up my weapon, refill my health. Ah! Hello, Barroth. How about you? How about you start limping? Probably not for a while. This guy, even though he's not overly difficult, I feel like he does have a lot of health. Or again, recently I've just been trying to kill him with a sword for some reason instead of my usual hunting horn, which seems to do more damage, in my opinion. Oh! Oh, gosh. Alright, I'm gonna get out of the way. No, I wanna get out of the way. Did that actually hit me or did it miss me? I don't remember. I don't recall. I got a little sliver of red on my health, but... So I'm inclined to think that it hit me. Oh, thank you guys. Thanks for the health. That's their other job. They do magical dances so I get health, and they distract the monsters so that I can position myself or get my ducks in a row. Alright, yeah! Take him down again! Alright, lady, stop looking at the other direction. Cut his tail off or something, I don't know. Or we can waste the time, that's cool too. Oh, I think he's starting to limp! No, he's not. He's just mad again. Alright. Oh, he is starting to limp! Yeah! Okay, now he's gonna dig underneath. I don't know if he's gonna go to sleep. Possibly not. Where's he going? He's going back to area 3. He might try to fall asleep. Maybe I should wait a little bit and see if he does? Or I can be impatient and just go run after him. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go with the ladder. Oh, he did. He fell asleep. I think now would be a good time, too, if you could place, like, bombs and stuff near his face. I don't think he's too big on that. Alright, okay. Oh, I didn't get off as many hits as I wanted to, but that's okay. Oh, and he's roaring again. No, why are you roaring for, man? Don't be like that. Barris, don't be like that. Ah! Alright, again, you can also cut off this guy's tail as well. I don't know if I'm going to actually achieve that. Probably not. Because I'm not very good at aiming for the tail. I don't know how I'm avoiding that tail. That's awesome, actually. Alright. All the power. Oh, we got him! Yes! With all my super cool R-button combos. But yeah, for the long sword, if you can see in the top left corner, there's that kind of like pointy bar thing. If that reaches full, you can mash button the R, and you can like kind of increase the power or something. I have really no idea. But yeah, so I don't think we actually broke anything. We can break all the mud off of him, which is a bonus. You can cut his tail off. If you have like an impact damage weapon, like the hunting horn or the axe, you can bash his face in enough that this part of his head will come off. So that's really helpful. Did I get all my carbs? I did. Success, Cha-Cha and Kayamba! Also, yeah, from the first episode, I switched their masks, so it's their default masks, the ones they come with when you first find them. Yeah, I love Cha-Cha. I love Kayamba's dance. It's like an ass wiggle. It's cute. He's like, chicka-chicka-chicka-chicka-chicka-chicka-chicka-chicka-chicka. Yeah. Cha-Cha's more of a head bob. Goes with the music. Sort of thing. But no, Kayamba's got... He twerks, I guess. I don't like using that word. But yeah, he's a twerker. That's totally what he is. Alright, let's send the items to the reward box or whatever. So we got Barroth Scalp, Barroth Ridge, Barroth Shell. Apparently I have a lot of stuff. Lots of fertile mud, that's good. I already have lots of monster bone mediums. Or do I? Yeah, I got like... Oh, it's a small monster bone, I was gonna say. Armor spheres I'll take. I'll take this as well. That's good enough for me. The other stuff I don't really have any need or use of. So yeah, that was that. No new records, that's okay. That's just kind of a nice fight, too, because there's not a whole bunch of, like, little guys, like, in your way being a butt. Like, Ludroth or well, I guess the Jaggies were there, but Jaggies aren't a big deal. Oh, Cha-Cha has something to say to me. Cha-Cha, what do you need? Cha-Cha-Cha-Da! Bombs, potent yet feeling, fleeting, just like teachings of Master Philosopher Cha-Cha! Oh yeah, these two are very pretentious. They think very highly of themselves. When you place bomb, Cha-Cha also put bomb next to your bomb for maximum boom boom. Cha-Cha love boom boom. I knew that. Cha-Cha leave fuse lighting to you. You Cha-Cha minion after all. Oh, yeah, they think I'm their minion for some reason too. Oh, he has all the things for me to take. I'll take that. I'll take that. I'll take that. No, I'll take the killer beetle. That's money. Yeah, that one, that one. Yeah, I don't really need the rest. Is that all I had to say? Oh, their friendship increased for me. This usually happens. I think you have to like, yeah. Because at first they don't like each other when you get them together. And then I guess they have that musical level and I guess mine filled all the way up so that we're at level 2 now and they're not as hateful and spiteful. If you want to know the story between them, buy the game. Play the game. Or watch other videos. I guess you have that option too. But I recommend you buy the game. Anyways, so that was the Barroth for this episode. In the next episode, we are going to take on the Great Roggy. Similar to the Great Jaggy, but with a twist. So I'll see you guys in the next episode.
Thank you.